on the 24th of November 1951 as an organization like many other Islamic movements all over the world to bring forward the Islamic agenda covering all spectrums of life, especially in the sector of siyasa, politics, tarbiyah, education, and da'wah, proselytizing or preaching of Islam. Today in this conference, we are more than happy to share our thoughts on the role of the Muslim Ummah, the role of Muslim youth in Ummah building. And it is also our pleasure to highlight some of our programs and initiatives, especially by the youth wing in realizing this sacred mission. Our youth, our future. Our Ummah is our responsibility. It has been said time and again that the future of our Ummah lies in the hands of our Muslim youth. How the youth of today can shape the world of tomorrow is the pivotal key in determining this Ummah future. In a world full of social, political, and economic challenges that transcend geographical boundaries, the Islamic world is in dire need of novel and diverse perspectives to resolve urgent global issues. Youth are generally filled with boundless and towering ambitions. It will be a great waste of human resources if we, as Muslim youth, are not given an opportunity to exercise our exceptional talents. This Ummah, as mentioned by Mr. Tamil just now, needs a means to mediate and enhance our capabilities to achieve a brighter and more outstanding future. We need to try our level best to promote the missions of integration, Islamization, internationalization, and comprehensive excellence in our outlook and pursuits for the Islamic struggle. Revolution, as we have seen during the Arab Springs, has always been spearheaded by the inexhaustible fervor and enthusiasm of youth. But after the initial stages, and once the revolution has come to pass, the time has now come to apply wisdom, astute reflections, and ingenious thoughts into tangible solutions to the many maladies afflicting the Ummah. Indeed, we as the young generation is the best generation to champion this intellectual enhancement, character development, and physical strength and endurance. We have a great potential to succeed if we endeavor to develop our human resources, i.e. by our own unique brand of Muslim youth, replete with esteemed qualities. This endeavor to groom youth with not only intellectual capacity and spiritual holiness, but also physical strength and emotional stability will give rise to an outstanding generation of mentally, physically, and functionally capable human beings in this chaotic era we live in. History has witnessed the birth of world-class Muslim youth with great hearts, coloring human civilization with their firm belief in the power of ideology, giving rise to the integrity and single-minded pursuit of their struggle. Who has never heard the name of Muhammad bin Murad, a brave and righteous young man who at the tender age of 23 led a quest to open the city of Constantinople on 20th Rabiul Awal at 157 Hijriah, which is on the 29th of May 1453 Masih. He was immensely successful, eventually became known as Muhammad al-Fatih, where Constantinople now known as Istanbul or Istanbul, where we are having our conference today. And surely many will want to emulate Osama bin Zayed, a young enthusiastic youth who upon reaching 18 years old was appointed by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as the commander of Quraysh military garrison to lead them in a war against the Roman army in Sham. Intellectual development. Statistics shows that youth is the largest group in today's population. Thus, the young generation plays a tremendous and important role in determining the lives and fall of our Ummah. Needless to say that whatever we do and whatever that happens to us will certainly have implications for the future. Hence, the thoughts and minds of the young generation should be seen as the key to ensure sustainable development and progress of the Ummah. Our intellectual capacities must be enhanced. A paradigm shift is needed to enable us to understand, appreciate, and implement the advancements of science and philosophy in our daily pursuits. A lifelong learning culture with an added level of knowledge in all fields imaginable, and especially the latest technology, should be included in the minds of our young people. This should include steps to implement world-class educational system in all Muslim countries, with values and ethics as one of the most important agenda. Education represents an entity that may help us amass knowledge, instill the correct attitude, and bring about the potential to succeed in this life. Education reflects a determination to elevate Muslim countries to a higher level and towards the betterment of our Ummah. Thus, when we ask ourselves about the education system we want, we really need to question what we actually want, what we actually expect from our young people, and what we want for our Ummah. It is essential to achieve these long-term goals in order to position Muslim countries as international leading centers of excellence, leading centers of educational excellence and academic excellence. Hence, each and every one of us, and especially the younger generation, should rise to the occasion and take up this challenge. For surely this is not an easy task for just one set of shoulders. But collectively, together with the generation at the forefront with their enthusiasm, in line with the theme of this conference, Islamic unity for absolute peace, commitment and burning desire to succeed, the ultimate goal of producing a young generation of filaments with the end of them becoming polymers can be realized. In past, in Malaysia, we as the youth, we have established our educational system by our party, by our jamaah, from the very beginning. For example, at the nursery level, we have this Taman Asuhan Tunas Islam, known as TASTI. We also have one of the largest network of kindergarten in Malaysia, of preschool, known as Pusat Asuhan Tunas TASTI, with almost, or I think now it's more than 2,000 branches all over Malaysia. And we also have a primary and secondary school known as Sekolah Rendah and Sekolah Menengah Integrasi Tunas Islam, as well as few university colleges. And I believe in your countries you also have this educational system, so I believe we need to enhance the system and the networking in terms of education that we have now. Our philomath is seeker of knowledge and facts, while our polymath is a possessor of knowledge in multiple fields. This signifies an ardent desire to learn and obtain knowledge, fitting as the self-image of youth. So too are the words of Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah alayhi, when stating that you will not require knowledge except with six conditions: intelligence, an indomitable spirit, hard work and resilience, and an inherent capability, pious features, and plenty time. Spiritual holiness. In addition to the truth and outlook of the flourishing young minds, should also be founded on the basis of uluhiyah and rububiyah, as taught by our religion Islam. Intellectual development is not accompanied by spiritual holiness, will eventually produce robots that are adept in study and analysis of information, but in reality, nothing without the intellectual professionalism and integrity of character. The Islamic generation in its heyday were the absolute pinnacle of outstanding non-intellectuals. They have both the mastery of knowledge in science and technology, as well as the morality of scholars molded by the religious values and knowledge and Islamic teachings. This was brought upon by the themes and concepts conceived in the studies of the Holy Quran. So spiritual holiness is required in search of exemplary youth models. Pearls of wisdom, ethics and moral values should be unearthed from the Holy Quran so as to complement conventional knowledge to give meaning to our worldly life. Model behavior shown by the most outstanding human being, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him, His companions and Salafus Saleh should be emulated as far as possible in order for us to develop a generation of conscientious and virtuous young individuals. In this aspect, as I believe the other organization that present here today, PAS, our Jama'ah in Malaysia, has established our Tarbiyah module and syllabus that is being used to develop its members through various programs for its cadres, including Usra or group discussion, Liqa Fikri, Intelligentsia Gathering, Ijtima' Tarbawi or Educational Assembly, Mukhayyam Tarbawi, Personal Development Program, CAMP, and others. Besides that, we also have our very own Leadership Academy, known as Akademi Kepimpinan Pemuda, or AKP, for the enhancement of our youth leadership. Moreover, various bureaus have been formed to cater for the development of school students, youth, university students, graduates, and professionals. In short, the best advice that one can give the young generation in order to excel in this world and the hereafter is to possess a resounding belief and obedience to the Almighty Allah. This is in line with the advice of Luqman al-Hakim, one of the said posts of the wisdom we may apply in our daily life. He said, indeed, our life in this world is like a ship sailing in the deep sea where many have drowned. If you wish to survive, then let us journey on the ship called piety. Its compass failed to bring us back, and our trust in Allah as the ship sails. How many minutes I still have? Okay. Brothers and sisters, actually I would like to also mention about physical strength and emotional well-being. But by doing so, I just want to mention that in terms of physical strength, we mentioned last year when I attended this session, Mr. Mustafa Kamalak mentioned about the three imperialism that we have today. One of them is the military imperialism, cultural imperialism, as well as educational imperialism. And I think it's strengthened further by the speech by Mr. Tremel just now mentioned that we need to be strong in all these areas. So I just want to share some of the activities that we have in PAS. For example, we have this uniform unit called Jabatan Amal Malaysia, where this voluntary uniform youth is in desire to ensure that our members, especially the youth, capable to bring forward our struggle as the Muslim movement. Brothers and sisters, in conclusion, in the search of exemplary youth models of our next generation, the four elements, namely intellectual, spiritual, physical and emotional elements, need to be established and strengthened. All these four elements are required to complement each other in building character and a distinguished identity of our Ummah. Surely, knowledge, faith, good breeding and wisdom are what the fundamental elements which must be mobilized and continue to permit to the next generation. Remember that today's generation is the main determinant of the survival of our future generation. It is us who are instrumental in shaping the direction and making decisions for the future glory and distinction of our religion, nation and Ummah. And I'm very happy to be here today. This is my second year attending this International Youth Forum, and I believe this is a good platform for us to start and continue our struggle to ensure that Islam, inshallah, will achieve the glorious time that we have achieved before, inshallah. Wallahu a'lam, aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfiru li wa lakum, wa billahi taufiq wal hidayah. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you very much.
Thank you.